Now, if you are looking for the perfect weekend getaway, how about spending some time in the beautiful Top End? Our reporter David Robertson has just enjoyed a long weekend there. David, where are you coming? You look like you're in a bathroom right now.
Well, I certainly sound like I'm in a bathroom, Sarah, because you know what? I have been working very hard. I know that all of you guys agree. I needed some time away, so I decided to come to my spiritual home, that is, of course, the Northern Territory. And just because it's the tropical summer doesn't mean there aren't heaps of things to do, amazing things to see, and interesting things, the way, sorry, to cool down. And that's what I'm doing right here. We're coming to you live this morning from Crocosaurus Cove, which is right in the heart of the CBD. And this is the only place in the world that you can dive with saltwater crocodiles. I'm going to be having a swim this morning with Chopper, which is a 5.5-metre saltwater crocodile weighing around 850 kilos. And there's only about 135 mil of plastic and a very, very thin sheet of Speedo separating me from becoming his morning tea. So while I get prepared to be lowered down and having a little swim with him, take a look at my amazing weekend up here in the Top End.
Australia, you know, it's a lucky country for so many reasons, and one of those is just the ridiculous amounts of long weekends we get. But therein lies the problem. You know what? Ever since starting on Studio 10, I have not had one single long weekend, and I'm going to change that right now because I have decided to come to one of my most favourite places on the planet. It is my spiritual home. It is the Northern Territory. Oh, I love this place. And I've decided to kick off my long weekend right in the heart of the CBD at Hilton Darwin. Oh my goodness, these guys know how to do cocktails, they know how to do pools. This is gonna be fantastic. Oh, I'm not coming home.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
You know what? I'm a sucker for merch. You put a logo on it and I will buy 3 of them. So that's what's brought me here to the Perrott Markets. Now, these markets will stay open 365 days a year. It doesn't matter if it's wet season or dry season, you can find a bargain here. And this is where I'm going to start a little bit of Studio 10 Christmas shopping.
Jingle bells ring, dancing and prancing and jingle bells ring.
Right, well, I've had to put a stop to my Christmas shopping for an exclusive for you. Now, you guys might get, you know, a Rob Thomas exclusive and all that kind of thing, but I'm about to one-up you. These are the first mangoes of the season. These are locally grown NT mangoes. And let me tell you, that's the smell and, oh my goodness, that's a taste of summer. And you find all these local fruits right here at the markets. We're just going to stop for a minute.
That's a holiday in itself. That is sensational. I'll get a box of these. I'll get a box of these.
All right, I've taken a little break in my Studio 10 Christmas shopping because I'm so excited about the treats that I found for you. Now, Sarah, you're pregnant. We know that. It's been confirmed. And you've probably got a lot of itches that you can't reach. Well, not anymore. I found you a kangaroo claw scratcher. Now, I've tested this on my own body, and it gets into every nook and cranny. And believe me, you will be satisfied. That's for you, Sarah. Now, let me just find out what I've got you for Ita. Now, Ita, you're a classy lady. You like wine. So I've got this little wine opener for you. But, you know, it's all about the casing, what you hold it in. So I've got something very classy. The slip's right in there for that. And look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Kind of makes you wish that you were born a kangaroo, doesn't it? Now, all right, Joe, Jess, don't worry. I'm on the case for you too.
All I want for Christmas is you. Oh, yeah. I like beer.
Look, let me tell you, all of this generosity and this gift-giving, it really takes it out of you. So I've come down here to Lola's Pergola in Cullen Bay for a light refreshment. Can you grab the mango beer, please? Now, they tell me that this mango beer is just delicious and the way to refresh on a hot NT day. Let's have a look. Mm. Oh my goodness, that is fantastic. That is refreshing, it's fruity, it's tropical, it's summer, it's a long weekend. Alrighty, well, with that mango beer under my belt, I am ready for some adventure and excitement, and my good friends at Outback Floatplane Adventures are taking us now to Sweets Lagoon for an afternoon that we will never forget. It is an ultimate experience that you can do in half a day. That is how great the NT is. We're on our way there now. Alrighty, we have landed here in Sweets Lagoon, but the adventure doesn't stop there. Oh my goodness, no, it's just getting started. It's now time for a bit of Barrett on the barbecue and the Lagoon Cruise. Alright guys, I'll cut the onions. That was just fantastic. The barra on the billabong is just delicious. But now it's time to rev things up a bit with an airboat? I don't know what that is. As much as those crocs would like me to take a dip in with them to get cool, I'm not going to do that because there are plenty of croc-free swimming holes around the NT that you can cool off. And today I've chosen the sensational Litchfield National Park. This is where you're going to come and cool off in style. Bit of wine, some flamingos, beautiful waterhole, and a whole lot of new friends. This is the way to spend a long weekend.
And you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed.
It's just a fantastic weekend, and right now I'm having a little bit of morning tea with Chopper here, who has just got a beautiful smile. Let me tell you, it's quite disconcerting to be this close to a saltwater crocodile. Let's see if we can't give him a little bit more food here this morning, just so we can see his beautiful smile. Oh my God! Oh my goodness! That is quite something. That is amazing. Look at those jaws. It is so close and so weird to be up close. Oh my goodness!
Robbo, why do they call him Chopper?
I am happy to be over here. They call him Chopper because he doesn't have any front feet. Often it's common for crocodiles to lose their front feet, kind of like Chopper, the man lost his ears. A few deaths there. Yes, that's right. We better say a massive thank you for everyone at Tourism NT for making this possible. Of course, Nikki, she has been just sensational. And also, if you would like to have a trip up here, head to travelnt.com. You'll not be disappointed. And a huge thanks, of course, to Chopper and our friends at Crocosaurus Cove, crocove.com. If you want to be in here right now, it is certainly an experience you will never forget. I don't like what is behind me. guys, we'll see you shortly. I'm going to keep an eye on this guy.
You know what Robbo did to that mango? Well, Chopper might do to the mango what...
Do to Robbo.
I
just reckon Robbo is so brave.
Isn't he?
He is amazing doing that.
Oh, it's incredible.
It's a very big crocodile.
It's ginormous.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Oh.
Has anyone else noticed that there seem to be a lot of scratch marks on the person?
Oh, he's brave. He's a brave man.
He's very brave. Now,